the study of thermodynamics is based on the analysis of systems and the surroundings. The state of a system is defined by the properties of the system. The properties that define the state of the system are the pressure, temperature, volume, enthalpy, entropy, internal energy, and like this many more properties are required. Now there are, out of these properties, there are some observable properties which could be measured directly, such as mass, pressure, temperature, volume, etc. However, there are some other properties which cannot be measured directly, like internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, and so on. So these properties which cannot be measured directly have to be computed with the help of certain mathematical relations between the property observable properties, and therefore it is necessary that some relations be developed for computation of these thermodynamic properties. To develop these relations, certain mathematical relations are required. As already explained, the state of a substance can be specified by two independent properties, and all other properties at that state that then depend on the two independent properties that we have selected. These properties are known as dependent properties later on. Further, all thermodynamic properties are point functions. Say, for example, there is a system . This system has got certain thermodynamic properties: pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, etc. Out of these properties, these are the observable properties, and these are the other properties which cannot be measured. And any two of these properties can be taken as the independent property. Say we can specify it by pressure and temperature, and if pressure and temperature are fixed, then all other properties thereafter become dependent on this set of these two independent properties. Consider a variable which is a continuous function of x and y, and mathematically we can write z equal to function of x and y. X and y are the independent properties at a given state, and z is the dependent property at that particular state. For example, we can choose pressure, volume, and temperature. So pressure is a function of volume and temperature, or volume is a function of pressure and temperature, or temperature is a function of pressure and volume. In that case, one of them is a dependent property, and the other two are the dependent properties. Using the properties of partial derivatives, we can write for this z equal to function of x and y, we can write dz is equal to dz by dx at a constant y dx plus dz upon dy at a given x dy, where dz is the total differential of dependent variables in terms of partial derivatives of independent variables. Let us again consider dz. Dz is given by this, and this can also be written as dz by dx y dx plus dz by dy x dy. Here dz by dx y can be taken as m, and dz by dy can be taken as n. Then we can write this equation dz is equal to m dx plus n dy. If x, y, and z are point functions, the differentials are exact differentials, then dm by dy x will be equal to dn by dy at constant y. And also we can write for that particular function z equal to function of x and y, we can write dx by dy z, dy by dz x, dz by dx y, that will be equal to minus 1 always, and dz by dxy will also be equal to 1 upon dx by dzy. So these are the mathematical relations that we will use to develop thermodynamic relations between various properties. To develop these relations, we have to define a few functions. First of all, we define a Gibbs function. It is defined as the difference between the enthalpy and product of temperature and entropy, or we can write G, that is the Gibbs function, equal to H minus TS. Therefore, dG would be equal to dH minus S dT minus T dS. This is equation number one. And another function is Helmholtz function based on internal energy. It is defined as the difference between the internal energy and product of temperature and entropy. So Helmholtz function A is equal to U minus TS, or dA equal to dU minus TdS minus SdT. Further, from first and second laws of thermodynamics, we have already derived equations dU equal to Q minus PdV, or dU equal to TdS minus PdV. Because Q equal to TdS, we can write dU equal to TdS minus PdV. And from second law, dH equal to Q plus VdP, or dH equal to TdS plus VdP. Substituting the value of dU and dH in Helmholtz function here and Gibbs function, we get the relations dG equal to VdP minus SdT and dA equal to VdP minus SdT. We substitute the values of dU and dH from equation 3 and 4 in equation 1 and 2, and then we get equations 5 and 6. Using these 6 equations, we can derive Maxwell's relations, that is the partial derivatives for properties pressure, volume, temperature and entropy for a simple compressible substance to each other. And these relations are called as Maxwell's relations. Equations 3, 4, 5 and 6 are the relations involving properties, and these are the exact differentials, and therefore are of the general form dz equal to m dx plus n dy. The equations that we have derived is dU equal to TdS minus PdV, dH equal to TdS plus VdP, then dA minus SdT minus PdV, and dG equal to minus SdT plus VdP. The equation that we have just now derived in terms of partial derivatives is mdx plus ndy, Now comparing these equations with these equations, this is dz, this is TdS, this is PdV, and this is equal to this. So we can write dz by dx x is s du by ds at v. And dz by dy x will be equal to
equation and this equation, they give us the relations in the form of dz by dx is equal to this and dz by dy is equal to this, and therefore we can write the Maxwell's relations du by ds v will be equal to minus du by dv t. This is the first Maxwell's relations that we can derive with the help of the mathematical relations as shown here. So this is the first Maxwell's relations, dt by dv s minus dp by ds v, this is the first Maxwell's relations. Similarly, using the enthalpy relations dh equal to t ds plus v dp, we can write another Maxwell's relation, dt by dp s will be equal to dv by dsp. Using the second equation, using the same concept, the next relation dt by dp that has been shown here, that can be derived. And using the Gibbs energy equation, that is the equation dg equal to minus s dt plus v dp, we get another relation that has been shown here, d minus ds by dp t, that will be equal to dv by dt p, that is the second third Maxwell's relation. And the fourth Maxwell's relation would be from Helmholtz energy equation, that is dA equal to minus s dt minus p dv, that would give us ds by dv t equal to dp by dt v, that is the fourth Maxwell's relation. These are the four relations which interrelate the four the properties enthalpy, internalogy, entropy, pressure, volume and temperature, computed using the mathematical relations that have been derived just now. The other useful relations that could be that have been derived just now. The other useful relations that could be derived using the same equations 1, 3, 4, 5 and 6 have been shown here, du equal to Tds minus Pdv. Here u is a function of entropy and volume, and using this u equal to a function of s v, we can write du equal to du by ds v ds plus du by dv s dv. And comparing this equation with the equation m dx plus n dy, we get m as t and n as minus p. So du by ds v will be equal to t and du by dv s will be equal to minus p. So change in internal energy at constant for a given entropy would be equal to temperature, and change in internal energy with respect to volume at constant entropy would be given by change in pressure. So that would be given by pressure. So this is how we can find, with the help of observable properties, the changes du by ds and du by dv can be computed. Similarly, using the other relations dh equal to tds plus vdp, this relation shows that enthalpy is a function of entropy and pressure, ds and dp. That means it is a function of entropy and pressure, and with this equation h as a function of entropy and pressure, we can write dh equal to dh by dsp ds plus dh by dps dp. If this equation is compared with this equation, we get dh by ds is equal to t. You can see dh is dh by dsp ds, whereas dh equal to tds. So tds is equal to dh by dsp ds, and therefore dh by dsp will be equal to t. Similarly, dh by dps would be equal to v. So again, change in enthalpy and change in entropy, or change in enthalpy and change in pressure, is measured in terms of observable properties T and V. Another relation we can use, dg equal to s dt plus vdp. This has already been derived. This shows that g is a function of temperature and pressure. We can write g equal to f tp and F, if G is FTP, we can write dG equal dG by dT P dT plus dG by dP T dP. Again, compare this equation with this equation, we get dG by dT P equal to minus S and dG by dP T equal to V. From the other equation that we can use is Helmholtz function, dA is equal to S dT minus PdV. So A is a function of temperature and volume, and therefore we can write dA equal to dA by dT dT, dA by dVT dV, and comparing this equation with this equation, this equation with this equation, we get dA by dVT equal to minus P and dA by dTV equal to minus S. These relations have been written here again, they have been compiled and written as equation 11, 12, 13 and 14, and these give us the values of partial derivatives in terms of observable properties P, V and T, right. Then few more parameters they need to be defined. One is the coefficient of volume expansion. It is defined as the ratio of the change in volume with temperature to the volume at constant pressure. So beta we define as dV by dT P divided by V, that is equal to 1 upon V dV by dT P. dV by dT P comes here and 1 by V. So that this is the coefficient of volumetric expansion. This is definition of coefficient of volume expansion beta. And another parameter that we define is isothermal compressibility K. It is defined as the negative of the ratio of change in volume with pressure, change in volume with pressure to volume at constant temperature. That is, this is the change in volume dV by dP at constant temperature, negative of this minus divided by V, or the isothermal compressibility K is given by minus 1 upon V dV by dP T. We can derive a relationship between beta and K. Let V is a function of pressure and temperature. V is a function of pressure and temperature always. And if V is a function of pressure and temperature, we can write dP by dT V dT by dV P into dV by dP T. This is equal to minus 1. From this dP by dT V equal to 1 upon these two terms, 1 upon dT by dV P into dV by dP T. Or we can write this as dV by dP T dV by dP at constant pressure dV by dP T dV by dP T that is minus beta V upon minus K V, and that gives us beta by K, or beta is equal to K into dP by dT V. A substance can be defined as a compressible or incompressible if there is appreciable change in volume during a process. Change in volume can be related with beta and K as already explained, and there we can write V is a function of pressure and T. Then dV equal to dV by T at constant pressure dT plus dV by P at constant temperature dP, or dividing this equation by V, we get dV by V equal to 1 upon V dV by dT P dT plus 1 upon V dV by P T dP. Substituting the values of this as beta, this parameter we define as beta, beta T, and this we have defined as K, so minus K dP. So dV by V is equal to beta T minus K dP. Now, next comes specific heat relations. The specific heat relations, by definition, the specific heats for a gas are specific heat at constant volume and specific heat at constant pressure. Specific heat at constant volume is defined as the quantity of heat supplied for a given temperature rise when the volume of the gas is kept constant. So, Cv will be equal to dQ by dT at constant volume, and change in the heat supplied at constant volume is always equal to change in internal energy dU. So CV can be written as dU by dTV, and dU by dTV can be written as dU by dSV into dS by dTV. This is by chain rule. We can write dU by dT is dU by dS into dS by dT in, at constant volume, and this we can write as T. This we have already proved that this is equal to T. Just now we have derived that dU by dSV is equal to T. So this will be equal to T into dS by dT at constant volume, and differential of CV, partial derivative dCV by dV will be equal to T into D2S by dV dT. We differentiate it with respect to V, then this will be T into dS by dTV, differential of this with respect to V, and D2S by dV dT it becomes. And therefore we can write differential of this with respect to V, and D2S by dV dT it becomes. And therefore we can write dCV by dV equal to T into d by dt ds by dv. This can be written as d by dt of ds by dv. This parameter has been rewritten as d by dt ds by dv, and this parameter from Maxwell's relation is equal to dt by dt at dcv by u, and therefore this is equal to t into d2p by dt square. The relation between pressure and temperature is known, and knowing the relation between temperature and pressure, dCV can be calculated. Similarly, by definition, specific heat at constant pressure is the total heat supplied at constant temperature when pressure of the gas is kept constant. That is Cp. dQ is equal to dH. dQ at constant pressure is equal to dH. Substitute here, Cp becomes dH by dTp, and dH by dT can be written as dH by dS into dS by dT at constant pressure, or this parameter is equal to T. Therefore, this becomes T into dS by dTp. Again, in the same way, we can find out dCp by dT. Find out the derivative of Cp with respect to P. This becomes T into D2S by dP dt, or we can again rewrite this as dCp by dt, dCp by dp at constant temperature is as T into d by dt ds by dt. Ds by dt from Maxwell's relation is equal to minus dv by dtp, and therefore dCp by dt becomes minus T into d2v by dt square. So dCp by dt in terms of the second derivative of volume and temperature can be found out, and that gives us change in specific heat at constant pressure in isothermal case. Now we can write we have to find out Cp minus Cv, and Cp minus Cv, for Cp minus Cv we substitute the values of Cp and Cv here, and if we substitute the values of Cp and Cv, the equation becomes Cp minus Cv equal to T dS by dTp minus T into dS by dTV. Now S is a function of pressure and temperature. Let us assume S is a function of pressure and temperature. We write dS equal to dS by dTP dT plus dS by dPT dP, or dS by dT would be equal to dT. We divide it by dT, it gives us dS by dTV, that is equal to dS by dTP plus dS by dPT into dP by dT V. Take this on the other side, we get dS by dP, dS by dTP minus dS by dT V is equal to this equation. Now the Maxwell relation gives us this term. On the other side of the equation, we get dS by dTp minus dS by dTv equal to minus dS by dPt into dP by dTv. The Maxwell relation is used, and we can substitute dS by dPt as dv by dt p. Substituting it here, we get Cp minus Cv is equal to minus T ds by dp T into dp by dt v, or T equal to dv by dt p into dp by dt v. So, Cp minus Cv in terms of observable properties, derivatives, volume, temperature, pressure, temperature can be calculated, and values of Cp minus Cv can be found out. Similarly, ratio of specific heats is also an important parameter that is required in most of the thermodynamic relations. Gamma is given by Cp upon Cv, and this is substitute the value of Cp and Cv here, and if we substitute the value of Cp and Cv here, T ds by dt p divided by T ds by dt v, T cancels away and it is ds by dt p divided by ds by dt v. This equation can be written as, by chain rule we can write this as this, ds by dt p can be written as ds by dpt into dp by dt s, and ds by dt v can be written as ds by dvt into dv by dt s. And if we can write it by chain rule, we can take the parameters dp by dt s into dt by dv s divided by dp by ds t multiplied by ds by dv t, and this on simplification gives us dp by dv s divided by dp by dv t. That is change in the derivatives of pressure and volume at constant entropy and derivatives of pressure and volume at constant temperature. Ratio of the two give us the value of gamma. Then the other relations that are required in most of the thermodynamic analysis are the TdS equations. We can assume S as a function of temperature and volume, S as a function of temperature and pressure, or S as a function of pressure and volume, and we can derive the three TdS equations. Let S is a function of temperature and volume, we can write dS equal to dS by dt v dt plus dS by dvt dv. Now, divide this equation, this dS by dt v is equal to Cv by T, this we have already proved, and dS by dvt is equal to dP by dt v. Substitute these values here and we get, multiplying by T, we get T dS equal to Cv dt plus T into dP by dt v dv. So, this is first TdS equation, TdS is equal to Cv dt plus TdP by dt v dv. So, TdS is the total heat, this is equal to Q. So, TdS, the total heat transfer, the heat exchange would be given by this particular expression. The second TdS equation, we assume S is a function of temperature and pressure, and when S is taken as function of temperature and pressure, we can write dS equal to dS by dtp dt plus dS by dpt dp. dS by dtp by definition is equal to Cp by T, and this expression we can write as from Maxwell's relation, we can write this as dv by dtp. So, substituting the values, we get Cp by T dt plus Cv by dtp dv. Multiply the equation by T, we get T ds equal to Cp dt minus T into dv by dt p. This is the second T ds equation, and next we can assume entropy as a function of pressure and volume. If we assume entropy as a function of pressure and volume, ds becomes ds by dp v dp plus ds by dv p dv. Now, ds by dp v into dp by dt v into dt by dv ds v is equal to 1, that is by chain rule, and substituting the values from this, ds by dp would be equal to dt by dp V into ds by dt V. This is dt by dp, this is Cv by T into dt by dp V. Similarly, this expression can be written as ds by dp will be equal to Cp by T into dt by dv. Just as we have derived, we can derive exactly in the same way we can derive this, and substituting the values of these two values, we get ds equal to this plus this, or Tds equal to Cv dt by p dp plus Cp dt by dv p dv. This is the third Tds equation which would be useful for analysis of thermodynamic processes. Then what is important, the entropy relations we have derived, then the other relations that are required for properties, internal energy and enthalpy. Exactly in the same way we can find out the relations for internal energy and enthalpy in terms of measurable quantities. Let us assume U as a function of temperature and volume, and therefore du will be equal to du by dvt dv plus du by dtv dt. Further, U is a function of entropy and volume also, so du is equal to du by dvs dv plus du by ds v ds. From this expression we get du by dv divided by dv, du by dv will be equal to du by dvs plus du by ds into ds by dv t. This will be equal to p, this is equal to t, and dp by dt v. So du by dv becomes minus p t dv by dt v. Hence du equal to cv dt. Du we substitute here, this is cv dt plus this equation we substitute for this, and we get du equal to cv dt plus t dp by dt v minus p dv, or cv dt into beta t by k minus p dv. Substituting the values here as we have already derived in earlier equations, we can substitute the values and we get du equal to cv dt plus beta t by k minus p dv. Similarly, we can derive expressions for enthalpy. Enthalpy is a function of temperature and pressure. Therefore, dh is equal to dh by dtp dt plus dh by dpt dp. This we can write as cp dt plus dh by dpt dp. Now, h as a function of entropy and pressure, we can write dh as this equation, dh by dps dp plus dh by dsp ds. This gives us the value of dh. Now we have derived expressions for du and dh, and if we integrate these equations, the change in internal energy u minus u o can be derived, can be written as integral of cv dt plus integral of the expression as shown here. We had derived du as this expression. Integrating this expression, integral du from u o to u, that is u minus u o, will be equal to integral of this plus integral of this. That has been shown here. Du minus u o will be integral t o to t cv dt plus v o to v integral t dp by dt v minus p into dv. And similarly, integrating equation for enthalpy, we get h minus h o is equal to integral cp dt from t o to t integral t dv by dt p minus dv minus v dp from pressure p o to p. So that gives us change in internal energy and change in enthalpy. So this is how the various thermodynamic properties can be computed, knowing the parameters
the measurable parameters pressure, volume and temperature, and using various thermodynamic relations, change in internal energy, change in enthalpy and change in entropy can be calculated. Another parameters which are required are the Joule-Thomson coefficient. This is a parameter which gives us the effect of fluid processed when the pressure drops, when the throttling takes place, when a fluid flows through a restriction, its pressure decreases and the enthalpy of fluid remains constant. The process being called throttling process. As the heat transfer and work done from the system are zero during the process, temperature of the fluid may decrease, remain constant, or sometimes it may increase. Now, this phenomena can be described by Joule-Thomson coefficient, that is defined by mu equal to dT by dPh. Suppose there is a fluid at high pressure and it flows through a restriction here, and when it flows through a restriction here, the pressure drops, and once the pressure drops, the other properties will also change. The volume will increase, the temperature may increase, temperature may remain constant, or temperature may decrease depending upon the properties of substance and the pressure ratio. And this phenomena of throttling at the enthalpy would remain constant as work done during the process and the heat transfer during the process remains constant. There is no work that is being done during the process, no heat that is being going out of the system or coming into the system, and therefore this is a constant enthalpy process, no work done, no heat transfer, but the properties are changing, and because of drop in pressure the temperature may change, may not change. And this phenomena is explained by the Joule-Thomson coefficient, and Joule-Thomson coefficient is defined as mu equal to dT by dP at constant enthalpy, enthalpy remaining constant. In this case, the temperature would increase if mu is less than 0, the temperature remains constant when mu is equal to 0, and temperature increases for the fluid when mu is greater than 0. This is the case which would determine whether the pressure, because of the drop in pressure, the temperature increases, decreases or remains constant. To analyze this, to find out mu, we let us assume H as a function of temperature and pressure. If H is a function of temperature and pressure, dH by dTP into dT by dPh into dP by dHT will be equal to minus 1. Here this is equal to Cp, this is equal to mu, and therefore Cp mu will be equal to minus 1 upon Cp by dHT. This is mu, this is Cp by definition, and therefore Cp mu is equal to this parameter. We can rewrite this as minus dH by dPt. And dH by dPt we have already calculated, this is equal to V minus T into dV by dTp, and if we can write it like this, mu Cp would be equal to T dV by dTp minus V. So value of Joule-Thomson coefficient would be given by this particular equation. Another relation that gives us the enthalpy of evaporation is the by using Clausius-Clipperance equation. This equation presents a relationship between saturation pressure, saturation temperature and enthalpy of evaporation. If a substance undergoes
a change of phase from saturated liquid to saturated vapor, the process takes place at constant temperature. The evaporation always takes place at constant temperature, and during the evaporation both pressure and temperature are independent of volume, and these properties, pressure, temperature, are linearly interrelated. This shows the change of phase. Suppose we boil a given quantity of water, the temperature of the water increases. When it reaches the saturation temperature, the evaporation takes place. Any addition of heat would not increase the pressure or temperature. Pressure and temperature during this phase remain constant and heat is absorbed. This is known as HFG, the latent heat of evaporation, and beyond this again the pressure and temperature would start increasing. So this phenomena of evaporation is being explained in Clausius-Clapeyron's equation. From Maxwell's relation we can write dP by dT V is equal to dS by dT, dS by dV at constant temperature. Phase changes from liquid to gaseous state, and therefore we can write dS by dVT is equal to SF minus SG divided by VG minus VF. dS by dVT, dS is the entropy in the gaseous state minus entropy in the liquid state, saturated state, and VG is the volume of the saturated vapor and VF is the volume of saturated water. So this dS by dV at constant temperature remains constant during the evaporation process, and therefore dS by dVT can be written as SG minus SF divided by VG minus VF, or dP minus dTV can be written as this: dP by dT is equal to dS by dV. dS by dV has been written as this, therefore dP by dTV will also be equal to this parameter. For saturated state, pressure is a function of temperature alone and independent of volume. So we can write dP by dTV as dP by dT because it does not depend upon the volume. It is independent of the volume during the evaporation process, and therefore dP by dT will be equal to SG minus SF divided by VG minus VF. Change in entropy is equal to enthalpy of evaporation divided by saturation temperature, temperature being constant. So we can write SG minus SF is HFG divided by T, SG minus SF as HG minus HF divided by T, or HFG divided by T. Hence dP by dT can be written as HFG divided by T into VFG. VG minus VF we write as VFG, and therefore this is the Clapeyron's equation. Clapeyron's equation is dP by dT is equal to HFG divided by TFG, and it is used to determine the enthalpy of evaporation from the data of rate of change of pressure with temperature, that is slope of the PT curve. The equation can be further simplified using some approximations. At low pressures, VG is very large as compared to VF, and thus VFG we can write as VG. By treating vapor as an ideal gas, VG can be written as RT upon P, and substituting these values we can write dP by dT saturated P into HFG divided by RT square, or dP by P at saturation is equal to HFG divided by R to dT by T square for saturated gas. And integrating this equation we get integral of dP by P is equal to log of P2 by P1 at saturation multiplied by HFG upon R to 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. This equation is called the Clapeyron's Clausius equation. These are the relations which are extremely useful for computing the data from the observable properties, pressure, volume, temperature, and the quantities of heat that are being supplied during a particular process, and so on. And these properties can be further tabulated. Of course, the absolute properties, the changes in properties can only be calculated. The change in properties from a fixed datum can be calculated with the help of pressure, volume, temperature, and the quantities of heat. And the properties tables for different substances can be prepared, and they are available in handbooks, and they can be taken, they can be used for thermodynamic computations for various processes. Thank you.